and Evi Hofmann. This is part one of our somatic exploration of natural fluid walking. So one element of walking is that each time when we walk, when we take a step forward, and when the leg straightens out, the hip moves out to the same side. Then we take another step, and then the hip moves to this side. Now I'm going to exaggerate that a little bit. I mean, when you walk, it's just very slight movement. But still, the hip needs to move, because when the hip is stuck on one side, for example, which can happen when we had trauma, or maybe through habituation, when we carried a baby on one hip for a while, some people will walk with a limp. And so then, the hip just doesn't move to the other side, because again, the hip is stuck here. Now, had an interesting experience with one of my clients, because she could already move the hip, everything was freed up, do the somatic exercises, the movements and hands-on treatment, and there was flexibility, but still the pattern of keeping the hip hiked up was just so habituated, it was really difficult to get out of this here. So first what we did, and I will show you that, and you can look at my previous post of the movement, the somatic movement of getting taller and reaching further. So we start out with this movement, and I will do it now really short. You can look at this other post then, just to get in this movement with one arm up, and then the other arm, and the opposite side when the arm is down or when the arm is up, the side is contracted, the whole side gets contracted and the hip and the shoulder gets closer together. And now, so this is what we practice with my client, and then when she came the next time, she said, when I do the exercise you showed me, then I can walk without a limp. And I was really curious what she was doing. And so she was actually walking this way. And sometimes when we do something that is novel for the brain, it's new, something very unusual, then we can get out of our pattern, what we had before. And so this is how it goes. So you go with one arm up, and that the opposite leg goes forward, and the other one. You see, but note what happens with the hip. This hip comes up, go up, and this hip comes up. There, we have this pattern of walking, and we can just have fun with this and move around, and just let's do it again. This arm comes up. And see, each time when we step here, the hip comes out. And then, naturally, this wouldn't be great to walk around the street like that. So you can take the same movement and now just do it a little smaller. So instead of bringing the arm all the way up here, just bring it forward a little, and she called that the hitchhike movement. It can help to just to move this forward. So let's do that. So the arm comes forward, and that you're not supposed to do. That, you know, when you go with the same leg, then you're going to start moving like this. So always remember, when you start here forward, the opposite leg goes forward. And this, and then see here how the hip comes out. And here the hip comes out. And then you can slowly just walk like that and then make this a little bit smaller. And then keep on practicing that. The hip, the movement of the hip. So with our next post, I'll show you some more explorations you can do to get some movement in your hips while you're walking, but also in this counterlateral move. And there's also other elements to our walk which I will teach you.